test 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. It works, you're alive. I have maybe in the past made a video about how to go to extreme from hard. But it was the only video I made regarding doubles and how to apply advice and how to press doubles and should put sliders on the config sticks, like shown here. And keep these four for macros. To give you a quick recap, and I also advise you to press doubles with both sides of the controllers. Now my next idea was on how to explain how to work on your muscle memory. Just to say, if I ask you where the triangle is, you on both sides can press upper in the right time, right moment. Especially, to my opinion, it should be helpful for, especially also for those still playing on hard and have issues with holding notes. So say on the right, they press a circle, and they need to do the other ones on the left, and then you have issues with keeping the circle pressed or doing the left presses. So, probably through the videos you've been using when after pressing the whole button, so you switch to the quad. At the end of the video, I will explain more about that and how we call that in the pro business. But for now, I will try to do use the D-pad more often than only the quad, and show you what I think is the best one, which you're gonna wear in the background, in my opinion, to test. If you can see the test your muscle memory. And I keep a future note these two express empty because I'm relearning myself to either do doubles with both hands. And this can depend, variate per users. Like once some have like opposite doubles like I usually did. But also others have like the common triplets. Which I will still make a video also about the triplets and how to identify them. But that's another one video. Personally, I think Sekiro no Ame, if I say that right, is a good practice chart on your, how do you call it, muscle memory. It is slow, you can easily one tap everything, it means if you see double you don't have to alternate like with one with your right and one with your left. It also has a lot of switches, instead of the usual hard charts that keep the more line combo. So I can play through the chart. You can keep an eye on the controller how to do it. One note before I start, the controller of the what I see in case to what gets recorded has a short delay of like 1 to 2 seconds. So the controller is not the gameplay is not delayed. That's the way it's recorded with my graphic card. I still have to figure out how to get the D-pad delayed so that it will go in line with the video of with the chart. But for now, the D-pad is not the synced. It's just recording software. But let's start and just keep an eye on the controller. Let's say if you say when you get circle, you say right. X down, square left, square right. I will explain hold, we call that hold, I will explain the D-pad hold tactic a little bit later, but that is more for people who want to care about scores and not go for only perfect. Loading the future time is longer, but I've played this, I've done this recently just after playing the hard chart. Usually when you see double you alternate, but because this chart is slow, at a slow pace, you can easily one tap most stuff. And like you can see, I can easily tell just by the nose that my thumb is pressing the right side. Or the right crack button. I I did that too snel, too quick. Like, I can one tap sim to everything, I've just, I just... I've perfected this while one tapping, I'm one tapping with every double, triple spam. So don't be afraid to one tap, don't alternate if that's too hard for you still. And then we'll make a chart on that also. Because next video that is planned is at least for triplets, like those circles. And maybe all alternative triples. Like you won't see that at the lower end X charts, maybe a little bit. But at the higher you'll see them also, so maybe something for the alternating video as well. Because I really think like you should work on your muscle memory at least the most, because can really help you indeed with alternating and spamming a lot. I like that kind of triplets. Like in that part you wouldn't be like, okay. My brain has to, like my brain has to press three. 3 times circular and 2 times triangle. It's also a bit reading actually, but... Save that. I'm not gonna finish the chart because I wanna leave the extra course just for now unchecked because I'm working on the perfect in every heart. But to be fair, I've never seen that chart or how do you call it ending because I usually hit the rainbow node. But now, if you are not interested in the term called hold switches, then the video ends here for you. But if you are interested, I will explain briefly what hold switches are. A way to like hold your notes better, so you get more space with your D-pad. Like you see me a lot of doing videos, you see me like if I press. If I press the, like the triangle and I go like to my quad or to the left back bumper to press the quad, it actually still counts as a note chart or as an hold. So I can still press them with my right thumb on the right side, but still hold the notes. I will show you more in practice of Sakurano Ame. Just pay attention to that chart when you see an old note. Oh fuck, that's the wrong button. See? If you wanna learn this, this chart is maybe not the best because it's slow and usually the beginning ends. But it is a good way to start learning to press the bumper after a hold. So it's also a tip if you want, if you care about your score. Like I want to say, get a perfect weight over 100%. Then you have to, or you have to learn to adapt to this strategy. So So it is also a good chart if you want, if you really want to learn it. To start capping holes and switch them to your back bumpers or to wherever you macro your quad. I usually have them at the back bumper because I usually have them at the my first practice, wow. I usually have them at the back bumper, but some people prefer to put them on the front bumpers as well and put the other macros under it. Still, so that's it for me this time. No fancy switching between Mega Mix and AFT anymore. Just one game, that's all. Because I'm gonna grind Future Turn a lot, get every heart perfect, which is also be released on the channel. I don't know if it will somewhere pop up on like a link to the video list if I made it already or uploaded some videos. Otherwise, you have to look out on the channel. I'm gonna make more D.Va tip from Road to Extreme. For now, practice. Practice a lot, take breaks. And it's really learning. For the next idea I will have in mind is triplets and alternating. This how to go from left. Or what is, how can you force your brain? How do I do big spams? How do you read them? All that kind of stuff and triplets. For now I'm gonna say have a wonderful day, weekend, evening, wherever you are, and then see this, and I will see you in the next video. And don't forget, if you like what you see, like, subscribe. If you want to see me once live on stream, I'm live every Wednesday and Saturday. Socials are down in the description. We have also the Discord there. If you have more questions, you always can ask them in me. I maybe not directly respond, but because of school maybe or something or personal life. But I will respond once I have time to you and try to answer it as best as possible. So for now, I'm gonna head out and say have an all a wonderful and nice day.